with you.
As long as he has existed, man has had to face danger. But today, it's not the big animals that are man's greatest enemies. Nor the smaller ones, for that matter. No, our worst enemies are infinitely smaller than that. Bacteria, viruses, poisons, toxins. Here are some that we need to fight.
If we could move into the stomach, we could cause good gastritis.
The nose makes the easy entry, and then you'll have a lovely cold.
Or a little allergy, believe me, that makes them feel sick.
What about influenza? What do you say to a nice Caribbean flu with high fever?
I still think infecting the stomach's a good idea. We can get in and develop with no problems at all. The body's defenses are useless.
Happily, we the body's sentries are here. The B lymphocytes, the T lymphocytes, the polynuclears, the macrophages, and many others. We're also known as white corpuscles. And in the human body, there are millions and millions of us. 200,000, more than the Earth's population, in one body. We protect it against foreign bodies and anything else that might harm it. Most of us are born in the bone marrow. Every day, 15,000 million white corpuscles come into the world. And all that would just about fill 3 big teaspoons.
Look, here comes old Fatty again.
Huh?
Watch this.
It's high time you were sent to school to learn how to behave yourselves.
Yes, they certainly are old enough to learn, I agree.
All right, kids, game's over. Get into groups of 4, quickly, please. We're going to school. But what on earth is school?
What do we do there? Will we have fun there?
What is it called again?
The thymus, the school for white cells. You're already a few hours old by now. And it's time that you learned what you're supposed to do.
What is the thymus and where is it?
Yes, tell us. The thymus is here. It's the organ, of course, where our body's defense systems are formed. And your job is the best of all. You have to learn to spot the difference between enemies and friends. You'll learn to fight and destroy all those enemies. Your lives will really be full of adventure. And very exciting, too. Well, even if only for a short while, you'll see. And now, let's not waste any more time talking. Get going, kids!
And now, class, I want you to have a closer look at your future enemies. Be careful, because you must be able to recognize them at first glance. There are all kinds of viruses here. They need the human body's cells to multiply. And so they invade the cells and destroy them. They give us all kinds of illnesses, like flu, measles, mumps, polio, and so on. Watch these war films and you'll see how they go to work. There used to be the disease smallpox, but thanks to vaccination campaigns, we've been able to wipe out the enemy by keeping the troops ready for combat.
Hey, pay attention. It's very important to know your enemies.
These are bacteria. They settle in snug little corners to multiply. They cause chickenpox, diphtheria, meningitis, and many other illnesses. Ah, here are the staphylococcus, or plain old coccus. They're extremely dangerous because they've learned to resist a lot of different kinds of medicine. They must be destroyed without mercy.
Hey, wake up! Otherwise you'll never be able to recognize all your enemies.
But then there are also good, friendly bacteria that our body needs. There are millions of them that help us digest our food and make vitamins. Of course, we must never, never attack them. Lieutenant Clear, would you mind joining us for a moment?
At your command, Colonel.
This is Lieutenant Clear, a brilliant officer in our police force, who will introduce you to a few of your friends, your travelling companions.
There will be times when you will have to go right into the blood vessels. For us lymphocytes, or white blood cells, this is easy, because we are able to change shape. Our blood plasma friends, proteins, lipids or fats, sugars, mineral salts, vitamins and many others. And you know, they make up half the blood. They're almost all food for the body. And the body constantly needs a large variety of substances because it renews itself all the time. The other half of the blood consists of the oxygen carriers, the fuel of the cell motors. And these carriers, who give the blood its color, are our friends, the red blood cells. And these little platelets repair our wounds and regulate the fluidity of the blood. They are also our friends, but these kind and harmless platelets are completely unprotected. And it's one of our pleasant jobs to protect these little friends from the enemy. So you'll understand how important it is to know who to attack or not, and never to make a mistake. This is inclined to happen due to poor education, and when it happens, the body becomes anemic. So please pay careful attention.
What did she say?